very rural out here. Middle of nowhere. Okay. Here's our next spot. Yup, this is the Hancock House. Let's check it out. Okay, so John Hancock, they said they cannot exactly tie to the guy of the signing of the Declaration of Independence. They're not really sure. So this is actually more of a Quaker area. I don't have all the information here. He was out of brochures. I should have recorded when he was talking. I forgot, so I don't remember everything he said. But basically, this was like a Quaker area. Let's check this place out. I gotta be a little quick because they have school groups coming in, and I don't want, you know, too many people in the way trying to record everything, so, because then it's a lot of editing, trying to edit people out. I try to keep people's privacy, you know, so. Let's just take a quick look at this place. Wow, all old currency. I love these little feather pens. It's really like old school, like very old school. I think I'm just gonna take pictures of all the information signs. Let's just browse through this really quick. Now I'll get a bunch of pictures. It's a bayonet. Seems a lot of these historic places have a very similar layout when it comes to indoors, because remember in Indian King Tavern Museum, it had something like this for a bar. It all looks very similar. I guess it's like the time period of the time, the style, you know how style always changes. So I guess at the time, this is the style, and that's what makes sense to me. That would explain that. Look at this. place is pretty big. I don't know if it's considered a mansion, but it's pretty big. Yeah, everything is like very similar. So like the Indian Tavern Museum, Indian King. It's gotta be because of this time period. Writing desk. That's pretty cool. Okay, so I can't go upstairs. But I think we still have the good majority already. What does that room lead to? Outdoors?
Upstairs.
Oh, upstairs.
Mm-hmm. You have any questions, Brad?
So that section of the house is a lot older than this section here.
Yeah, so 1734 is the largest. This smaller section in front was probably added on within 10 years of the house being built.
Oh,
so
1740s.
Okay. And then this room we're in now was probably... The estimates are around 1840s or so. Because by that point, the whole building was being used as a tavern.
Okay.
And so they built a larger kitchen back here.
I see.
There might have been a summer kitchen off the back of the tavern here originally, because that fireplace looks like it's been altered.
Yeah.
And so whatever was here, we don't know if it was just like a small little cook kitchen off the back, and this would have been the back entrance to the tavern at the time, so it makes sense if you have a small little house here and you could just bring food in and out of the tavern.
Yeah. So like I was saying, it looked very similar. That's because, you know, at one point it was a tavern, so that makes sense. Interesting. All right, let's check this place out now. So this was Civil War era. Ah. think I'm gonna get mostly pictures of this. It's a lot of stuff to read. This place smells authentic. Civil War era. Wow. This is an original camp chair during the Civil War. Cornelia Hancock's original camp chair. Huh. That is crazy. So this here, the guy was saying there's some leftover patterned brick houses from the Quakers behind this area. So the sign says that this bridge was used during the Revolution. I feel like it's probably remodeled since then because I don't think they had metal like that. The hell was that? This is Alloway Creek, I think. random shack there. Alright, well that's it for the Hancock House. Let's go to the rest of the spots now. Oh, there's one more actually in this little town here. Lower Creek Meeting House, I think it's called. So this is a Quaker meeting house.